Through the facilities of KYW in Philadelphia, the National Broadcasting takes pleasure in presenting a preview of Stan Kenton's Concert in Miniature, music in the modern mood, as progressive as today and as new as tomorrow. Direct from the Club Harlem in Philadelphia, we bring you Stan Kenton's interpretation of progressive music. We're sure you'll enjoy the vitality and imaginative quality of Stan Kenton. Now here is Modern America's man of music and your host, Stan Kenton.
Thank you very much, everybody. For those of you that are listening in, would like you to know about what is happening here. We've been pleased to adopt what the band has possibly warmed up at this moment. We've chosen a program that we hope that you'll enjoy. We've investigated fully the sound potential of the room here. The engineer has been here this afternoon. We've had balance tests. The producer is here. The audience is waiting. And, fellas, we have an overture to play here. And for this evening, we've chosen as an overture something that was written by a new arranger, a new guy with the orchestra, Gerry Mulligan. And as I've said before, I think it's dedicated to you and the Kenton Orchestra. There's a lot of organized playing, and then there's some freedom of speech that takes place here with Conte Candoli with the trumpet. So you'll hear a tenor saxophone of Bill Holman, and of course the alto saxophone of Boots Mussulli. Ladies and gentlemen, the overture for this evening's concert in miniature here will amount to a thing that's called, appropriately, Young Blood. Fellas, attention, please. The beat. One, two. We'll be right back. Thank you. You know, I think in time to come, when America has its own style of music, so to speak, it'll be the result of many things. The Latin American music has had a great influence on it. Every rumba, every tango will probably have left its mark. As I've said many times before, I don't know whether we were meant to be a Latin American orchestra or an American jazz orchestra. We play so much of the music. Here's a simple melody, a very simple melody in a minor key. There's some trombone by Bob Fitzpatrick, some rather exciting alto by Boots Mussulli, a thing that once was a phonograph record, still a record, played once more here. It's Francesca. Latin American instruments, please. On the nose. Thank you. You know, today we buy many things that are tailor-made. In fact, it's always considered quite a privilege if we can boast about something we're wearing that's tailor-made or something that's custom-built. You know, in jazz, that's one of the wonderful things about the music. So much of it is tailor-made and designed, we'll say, to fit a personality and his conception of his instrument. One of the most important instruments in all music is the string bass. We have a guy here that's contributed a great deal toward the things that we've done with this orchestra, as well as the concert orchestra. His name is Don Bagley, but we call him Bags. The Bags, that was the reason the title came about, a thing called Bags and Baggage. It's a bass solo. Bags, you must play off of this microphone here, so I'll be talking while you come forward, and we'll make it. Take it on the nose. Thank you. Thank you, Bags, very much. Now you can move back with the rhythm section right next to Ralph Blaze. Stand there, we'll call the next number. Do you know what the next number is? Well, I'll give you a clue here when I explain about it. You know, to establish a mood, you need a guy to write some music. An arranger, he conceives a melody, starts scoring it, and if it fits a guy and his feeling for the instrument, we generally wind up here with a soloist. The guy is Bob Fitzpatrick. The composition is Bill Russo's composition and adaption from the Innovations in Modern Music Orchestra. Here's a thing we call Solitaire. Gerry.
Yes, Dad.
You know, if you had an orchestra and you were playing in Philadelphia and you were doing a broadcast over the National Broadcasting System and you had a number in the book called Taboo. You do know Taboo, don't you?
Oh, very well, sir.
What would you say in introducing it?
Well, I'd say it was an unusual number when done by Stan Kenton, not after the way the composer had written it, perhaps. Perhaps Stan Kenton had written it over again.
I see.
Fashions and music.
You haven't heard it, have you?
No, I haven't.
You suppose if the composer is listening in, he would be angry at the treatment we're about to give it?
Oh, if he recognized it.
I hope he's in California at the moment, then. But anyway, Gerry, you know, Taboo is one of the nicest tunes, one of the greatest tunes, I should say, ever written in the Latin American vein, and we have a thing here that Johnny Richards, the guy that's so important to the arranging staff today, has conceived and written for the orchestra. Again, it has to do with the guy on trombone, Bob Fitzpatrick, mm-hmm. or some Alto by Boots Mussulli, and... Gerry, just give a formal announcement. Just say something like, Stan Kenton and his orchestra, Taboo.
The mighty Stan Kenton Orchestra and... that do?
That's a nice adjective.
Jerry? Taboo. Ready.
So far this evening, we have actually had very little what we might just call simple, well, you could call it toe-tapping music. Just something set to a beat here. Here's an instrumental that has already established itself as a very important part of the right side of the library. That's the instrumental portion. A few short solos, as I say again, a few chances for some of the musicians to express themselves and improvise solos. Here's a thing that's called a Jump for Joe. Thank you.
brought you a preview of Stan Kenton's concert in miniature, which will be heard regularly over many of these same stations starting next Tuesday night. Hear Kenton's refreshingly original conceptions of modern music. Music as progressive as today and as new as tomorrow. Our broadcast tonight came to you direct from the Club Harlem in Philadelphia through the facilities of station KYW. Join us next Tuesday, then, for another Stan Kenton concert in miniature with modern America's man of music. Consult your local newspaper for time. Jerry Warren speaking. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.